Hey, it's another day. I put the last coat of polyurethane on. Dried overnight. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to sign it. I do that with a diamond bit on my little Dremel here. So I will get the camera set up and I will start signing it down here. I put on The Stick by Gunther. So, get right back to you. It's upside down to you, but The Stick by Gunther. Turn it around. The Stick by Gunther. Okay, let me get your camera back up here. Now, I am going to find out where my grip should be, and I'm going to start doing the grip. So, talk to you in a bit. Okay, ready to start. I got the hole drilled, got the leather glued in. So now we start. This is actually the trickiest part, is getting this straight.
Thank you.
Well, sorry about that. I needed an extra hand for the gluing. I was kind of awkward here. I didn't have my glue sitting in the right place. So, anyway, there it is. All on. Yeah, I think it looks pretty good. About drop it all the way down to the rubber grip and then where I sign it. And let me roll it all the way around. There. And now I'm going to put a lanyard on here. That's still coming in the mail though, so I think what I'm going to do is give it a good polish and then set it up and let everything harden. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. I'm going to see if I've got enough room in this video to drill the holes and putting the lanyard on. So we'll see. Talk to you later. Hey everyone, I'm going to be doing the brass tacks on TIFF'S walking stick. I just wanted to show you that, you know, those are the brass tacks. I hope you can see them. And I got them all marked. These come out even to a half inch apart, and then I always move them 3/16 up above the edge of the groove, because these are quarter inch, so that gives it a 16th play and seems to work out pretty good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start center punching these with my center punch, my automatic. You know, I really found that does a grand job of getting those things right. So get the camera set, come back to you, and we'll do just a few of them. I'm not going to go through the whole bunch. So okay, get right back to you. Here we go.
Do the rest of them just by myself here.
Yeah, I got them all center punched, and I forgot to mention that the center punches like this are all adjustable on how much pressure you punch with, so you don't have to have this thing set on high to punch into wood. I crank it way down, in fact, so it just makes a nice little dent. And I tried masking tape this time instead of my blue painter's tape, and that was a pain to get off. So now what I'm going to do is I have 1/32nd inch drill bit. I just start a little pilot hole to set the tack in just to get it started. So I will be setting the camera back down here to make sure that you can see. I'm only going to do a few of them and then just do them by myself, because it's you've seen me do it before and it's probably boring. So get back to you in a bit. All right, I'm gonna start her going here. Okay, got all the tacks in. Want to show everything to you? I like it. I'm really enjoyed doing this one. For some reason, it really a nice stick, and I showed you how I did that, but I'm hoping you can see it. I colored my signature where I took it out. All right, well, that is the end of that stick until the lanyard comes in. I should be here tomorrow, Saturday, probably Monday or Tuesday. So when it comes in, get back to you and throw that in real quick, and we'll be done with this one completely. Appreciate you watching. Bye bye. Well, I'm back to finish up TIFF'S walking stick. I got a 3/8 hole drill in it. I didn't film it because there's really no excitement about watching a guy drill a 3/8 hole. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to use some of the same stain, and I'm going to go in and stain inside this hole. I know you won't be able to see it all, but I just want to get it a little dark in there. Getting it all over everything. Okay. Now, I'm gonna take the stain. There you go. All right, got her stained in there pretty good. Don't know if you can see it or not. I doubt it, but and I'm going to let it dry a little bit and then run the lanyard through it. So be back to you in a bit. Okay, I'm back, and I've cut the lanyard down. They come squared off at the end, but I cut them down to a point. It makes it a little easier to push it through that 3/8 hole, because that is exactly the size of that leather, and then pull it out. Now, the lanyard will be set. I should say lanyard, not lanyard. So it's flat at a 90 degree. And then we have a concho that goes with it. And I picked a heart for the daughter. I think it's a very pretty. And of course, you run the pieces up through. Oops. Good. And then back down through it again. Now you have to adjust it to however it feels good to the person that's using it. And whatever is left over here, I usually cut it off right even with the end of the concho. Because you don't want that sticking out where they have to piddle around with it. But that's it. Let me get the camera back up here. Okay. And then that is it. That is the concho. And like I said, it's got to be adjusted to the person. But that's the gist of it. How it goes in. There's all different kinds of conchos. I mean, you can buy conchos from Tandy Leather and all of them. There's just hundreds of those things out there. So I guess that's about it. I'm hoping to get all of this into one last video. So I'm going to shut this one down. And remember, get your hiking, walking sticks, your canes, and get out there. Get out there and walk and hike, because nature is beautiful.